Hi, everybody. Welcome to this Tech Talk. My name is Peter Dubois, and I'm a technical designer at Cegeka. In a previous video, we discussed four ways of integrating data between Microsoft Dynamics 365 customer engagement and Microsoft Dynamics 365 finance and operations. In today's video, we will zoom in on one of them, dual write. We will discuss what it is, how to set it up and configure it, and also some pros and cons of dual write. Now, first up, what is dual write? Dual write is an out-of-the-box integration platform that integrates your data in a real-time, tightly coupled way between your customer engagement apps and your finance and operation apps. Now, how do you configure dual write? Before even starting about configuration, let's talk about the system requirements. Dual write works on all cloud versions of customer engagement and finance and operations. Because of the continuous updates that Microsoft does on both applications, any version will do. So if you have both applications running in the cloud, then you're all set and good to go. Now, before you start configuring dual write, there's some minimal setup to be done in finance and operations and customer engagement. If you start from a brand new finance and operations environment, all setup is done through a deployment wizard in LCS, Lifecycle Services, which is a collaboration platform that, amongst many other things, serves as an admin portal to manage your applications. Once your setup is done there, you're all good to go. For existing finance and operations environment, all setup is done within the finance and operations application. But before going there, you need to install two solutions in your customer engagement environment. You can get those solutions from Microsoft AppSource. After you've installed those solutions in customer engagement, there's a handy wizard in the finance and operation apps that guides you through setting up the dual write. This is where you select which environments you want to link to each other and which legal entities you want to sync. To help you out with this process, there's a very handy health check that validates if you meet all system requirements to start configuring dual write. Once your environments are linked, all configuration is done in the dual write UI within finance and operations. Because it's a low-code platform, everything is done through a handy designer. Here you can simply enable existing maps, customize existing maps, or create your very own custom maps. When you hit the save button, the system automatically validates your maps to see if key fields are missing, if data types match between the two systems, if maybe you have some double field mappings, and so on and so on. Once you're done with the configuration, simply hit run and your integration is ready to go. Now let's discuss application lifecycle management. Your implementation project will have multiple environments. There's the development environment, which is used for your development of the mappings. Then there's a test environment, a quality assurance environment, an acceptance environment, and your actual production environment. Now let's talk advantages of dual write. First of all, configuring dual write is a very easy experience, which means that even a non-technical user can set up a complete integration within a couple of hours. Dual write is out of the box and is totally free. You don't need any servers or virtual machines whatsoever, and there's no running costs once your integration is set up. It's a real-time integration, which means that any change you perform in one application immediately gets synced to the other application. It's also even transactional, which means that you can set up validations in your target system, and your source system has to respect those validations. Let me give you an example. Let's say that in your finance and operations app, you have a postal code validation. This means that when you create a customer with a non-existing postal code in customer engagement, and you try to sync that customer to finance and operations, finance and operations will validate this postal code, will say, no, this is not an existing postal code, and will tell that to customer engagement. This means that the account will not be created in customer engagement as long as it doesn't follow the validation rules of finance and operations. Microsoft has provided a lot of out-of-the-box mapping concepts. For example, there's customer integration, vendor integration, there's product integration, inventory integration, and many more. Dual write supports filtering of records, which means that you can decide which records you want synced and which records you do not want synced. This might be, for example, handy in a scenario where you only want to sync accounts that are already customers, but not the prospects. Another advantage is that you can add some simple transforms to your field mappings. There's the value map, which means that when dual write receives a certain value from customer engagement, it puts through another value to finance and operations. For example, if dual write receives Belgium from customer engagement, it will sync BEL to finance and operations. There's a default transform. If there's no value in a field in your customer engagement app, dual write will put through a default value to finance and operations. There's also a truncate transform. This means that when dual write receives a text which is longer than a predefined length in characters, it will first truncate the text and then put it through to the other application. Finally, one of the most impressive features, in my opinion, is something called initial sync. When enabling your map, the system will check for pre-existing data in both applications and will first sync that data so that the data is in sync within the two systems. As an added bonus, when you enable your map, the system will show you which dependent maps you need to enable first in order to have a successful synchronization. So far, this all sounds pretty magical. However, there are some cons or pitfalls that you absolutely need to take into account when you consider using dual write. When we first started implementing dual write, we made the mistake of seeing customer engagement and finance and operations as two completely separate applications. And the integration was done in a late phase of the project. As a consequence, this conflicted with some customizations and designs that were already performed in the beginning of the project. It's now very clear to us that a dual write implementation has to be a joint project between CE consultants and finance and operation consultants. You need to align from the start and you need to see both applications as one integrated system. As I mentioned in the pros of this video, Microsoft provides a lot of out-of-the-box mappings. Although they are very elaborate, chances are that they will not be enough to meet your specific business requirements. If you're lucky, you might get away with simply customizing an existing map, but in most cases, you will end up with custom development, which costs time and money. And not only it has an impact on your budget and on your timeline, but it also has an impact on maintainability of the system and the configurability. I mentioned that you have to install two solutions in your customer engagement environment. Those two solutions, they add a lot of overhead to components that you might not even want to integrate. I'm talking about plugins, forms, views, customizations. For example, the dual write solutions, they add a plugin to your quote entity that makes the legal entity required, which is not handy because maybe you don't want to integrate quotes to begin with. Again, reworking or disabling all these added components can take some time and some budget from your project. Another disadvantage is the security. All actions are performed within the context of an application user, so there's no actual way to see which records a user can modify in a target application from within the source application. Another downside to this is auditing. There is no way to see which actual user made a modification on a record, because everything is done from the application user context. Now, although you can go a long way with the out-of-the-box mappings and functionalities, you most likely will end up being blocked if you have some more complex integration scenarios. Let me give you some examples. The mappings, they are entity to entity, so record to record. Let's say you want to use data from a related entity. This is not possible within dual write. So if you want to integrate a contact and also some account information for that contact, this is simply not possible. Moreover, there's no way to add conditional logic to your integration. Some common patterns like if a dropdown contains value A, take the value from this field. If it's another value, take it from another field, is simply not possible dual write. I mentioned before that the system is transactional and tightly coupled. While this can be a pro, this also poses some disadvantages. First of all, there's something called pause catch-up functionality. Normally, this functionality makes sure that even when an application is down, all changes are queued up and are processed by the system once the application is up and running again. Now, this all sounds good in theory, but in practice, we noticed that this pause catch-up functionality almost never works like you want it to. So instead of doing what it should, it will give you a lot of headaches. Furthermore, we've noticed that on multiple occasions, notifications of something going wrong are actually not sent to the IT department, which means that they probably don't even know when something actually went wrong. This way of integrating is point-to-point, which means that two applications are tied together. In application landscapes, where multiple applications need to receive information from a source system, we generally like to use a centralized hub where all information from the source system is posted, and target systems that need this information can simply subscribe to this hub, read the information, and process it. Within Joule Write, this is not possible. Another big downside for me is that although Microsoft states that there's a combined view for activity and error logs, we can state that this is actually only partially true. For initial sync of your data, there is a combined view of errors, but this view and the information that you see there is very limited. When an error is thrown during your live sync in your customer engagement application, the user will see a notification that something went wrong. But if you didn't enable logging, the user can simply click away this message and no one knows what happened. And even if you do enable this plugin trace logging, the logs are very complex and are hard for a non-technical user to make out what happened. On the finance and operations side, all logging is done within the database, but only if you have enabled the debug mode on your project configuration. Enabling the debug mode has a severe impact on your performance, so it's advisable not to do that on a production system, and especially not for transactional data. The fact that finance and operations in general is a lot stricter when it concerns data or data validation can pose a real problem. Let's take a country mapping as an example. In customer engagement, the country field is a free text field. User can input whatever he wants. However, on finance and operations side, the system expects the 3-letter ISO code. So when a user in customer engagement enters Belgium, Belgique, BE, or any other variant, finance and operations will expect BEL. This can make your mappings and transformations a real challenge. Another disadvantage is that the data model in both applications is often very different. Microsoft is trying very hard to even out these differences, but there's a lot of work to be done. And for the parts that they already have evened out, you can see that there's still a lot of limitations and the whole thing feels kind of artificial. Let me take the product data model as an example. In customer engagement, the product entity has a pretty simple data model. There's your product entity, maybe some product information, some relationships, price list items, and that's it. Finance and operations, however, the product data model is very complex, and some of the concepts are even unknown in customer engagement. For example, you can have a product master with some product variants. The product master then would be a t-shirt, and the variant would be a t-shirt color blue, size medium or size large. In finance and operations, this is all one product with several variants. But in customer engagement, you will need to create a product for every variant that you have. Needless to say that your list of products in CE will be extremely long. Now, the other way around, the concept of price lists, for example, is known in customer engagement, but not in finance and operations. The way that Microsoft solved this problem is that every product coming from finance and operations will be added to the first price list it encounters in customer engagement, which is not very handy for an organization that wants to use multiple price lists. Also, the product integration currently is only supported one way, from finance and operations to customer engagement. While in most cases this would make perfect sense, it still completely blocks the user in customer engagement from creating new products. And that's only one example. I can give you a lot more, but that would probably take us way too far. Now let's talk again about application lifecycle management, which I mentioned in the pros, but also shows up now in the cons. Microsoft has already made a lot of progress when it concerns application lifecycle management, but there are still two major downsides when it comes to this. First of all, it's still not possible to completely automate your deployments. There's still some manual user interactions that are needed. And as we all know, the more user interactions you get, the more chances of errors you have. And second, and even worse, upgrading a map cannot be done while the map is active or paused. It has to be completely disabled in order to upgrade it to a new version. This obviously has a big impact for applications that need to be up and running 24/7. And finally, as we all know, Microsoft is putting a lot of effort in continuously updating their applications. Most of the times this is a good thing, but it can happen that when you update either your customer engagement environment or your finance and operations environment, that it actually conflicts with the setup or the configuration that you already have. This means that after a big upgrade of the system, being it customer engagement, finance and operations, or dual ride itself, you will have to take some time and budget for regression testing to make sure that everything still keeps working. To conclude, we love the idea of having an out-of-the-box, near real-time, designer-driven integration between customer engagement and finance and operations. We see that Microsoft is putting a lot of effort in continuously developing and improving this product. However, because of all the cons and pitfalls that we've mentioned, we remain skeptical. We see some strong use cases to use dual write, but for more complex, performant, and highly available integrations, we would advise you to take a look at, for example, Azure Integration Services on top of dual write. It should be clear that configuring your integration requires your customer engagement consultants and your finance and operation consultants to work closely together. Each application has its own way of working, and customizations will need to be done in both systems. Because of everything that we discussed here in this tech talk, it's very clear that there's a lot of things to take into account when designing and configuring your integration. Obviously, we as a specialized integration partner are happy to advise and assist you in your integration requirements. Also, we closely monitor and evaluate updates on this platform. So please click the bell icon to stay in touch for future updates.